In this video, I'll cover creating a domed roof for a circular or round building. In Chief Architect, a circular building must be created with at least two wall segments. Let's take a look at the process. To help guide me in creating a circular room, I'm going to use the line tool and I'm going to click and drag to create a 10-foot line. As I'm dragging this out, before I release the left mouse button, I'm going to press the tab key and I'm going to enter in 120 inches or 10 feet to create a very specific length line. Underneath the wall tools, I'm going to grab the curved exterior wall tool. I'm going to click on the end of the line, click around, snap on the other end to generate the first segment of the curved wall. At this point, I'm going to double click on the wall. On the general panel within the wall specification, down in the curved wall segment, I'm going to make sure that the radius is to the outer surface of the wall, and then I'm going to set the exact distance for the radius at 60 inches. I'm going to be sure to lock the two ends. As I mentioned earlier, it takes two unique wall segments to create a circular room. As I drag the singular wall around to connect, notice that it stops short of the full circle. In this case, I actually need to draw two different wall segments. Let me press undo. First approach is to click on the wall, use the break tool, place a break on the wall segment, and then go ahead and close the circular room. The other approach, I'll go ahead and press undo a couple of times, is to take the wall segment you've already drawn, select it, use the copy tool in the lower edit menu, reflect about, click on the line. That will also create the other wall segment, and when you click inside, you'll see your room definition defined by the shading. Let's go ahead and build the roof. In the build menu, I'll come down underneath the roof and select build roof. I'm going to turn on the automatic rebuild roofs. For the pitch, I'm going to leave it at 5 and 12. Towards the bottom is an option that you can create a segmented angle at your curved wall. Currently, it's set at 15 degrees. That will facet at 15 degrees around the outside of the wall. You can change this to be a lower number. Might take a little bit longer to build. This is going to give you a smoother finish. I'm going to go ahead and leave this at 15 degrees. In my roof plan view that I'm using, you'll see the roof plane labels. It gets pretty noisy. I'm going to tap on one of these, use the open object, and just simply come in here and turn off the label so it's a little cleaner to see. Let's go ahead and now take a 3D overview using the perspective full overview camera. And you can see the default roof is built at 5 and 12. If you want to rebuild the roof, go back in, and if I change this to 12 and 12, you'll see that the roof becomes much steeper, more like a turret style. To dome this roof, let me press the undo button one time to get back to the 5 and 12 roof, and then I'm going to tile my screen by pressing Shift F6. On the plan view side of the screen, I'm going to come over and I'm going to choose the roof plane tool. Move my cursor out to the left of the design, hold my shift key down, and I'm going to left click to drag a marquee around all of the roof planes. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and use the open button in the far left hand corner of my screen. On the general panel inside of the roof plane specification, toward the bottom is the option to curve the roof. At the ridge, which is at the peak, I'm going to come in and I'm going to change the angle to be 5 degrees. When I make this change, the program is going to notify me that it may need to turn off the automatic rebuild roof planes to continue because I'm going into manual mode. Once I close the dialog, you can see in the 3D view, we've been able to easily create the dome shape for the roof. When you have a circular building and you place your doors and windows, let's start with the door. Place a door inside of the structure. You notice as I zoom in that the door is actually not cutting the wall properly. There's an option for doors and windows to have a circular option. Inside of the door dialog, on the options panel, you come down and there is an option in a curved wall to use a curved door. Once I make that change, you'll see the door now fits much better into the wall. Rotate around just a little bit. Let's take a look at placing a window. And in this case, the window looks pretty good. If you open up the window, on the casing panel is an option down here underneath the curved wall casing. You'll see that I already have the option selected for radial, which will smooth that casing. To learn more about the roof tools, please see the built-in help file as well as our other videos. Thanks for watching.